A very good morning to all of you. Miss Rita here. In geometry, class 9, chapter number 3, triangle. In previous video, we have done practice set number 3.1. Today, we will continue with the practice set number 3.2. Congruence of triangle. We know that a segment placed upon another fit with it exactly, then the two segments are congruent. Now, second is congruent angle. If a angle placed upon another fit with it exactly, then the two angles are congruent. Congruent triangle. If a triangle placed upon another fit with it exactly, then the two triangles are congruent. Student, points to remember: triangle ABC and triangle PQR cover each other exactly, then we write triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. If two triangles are congruent, then corresponding angles and corresponding sides of those triangles are also congruent. Corresponding sides of congruent triangle is written as CSCT. It stands for corresponding side of congruent triangle. Corresponding angle of a congruent triangle is written as CACT. Test of congruence. First test is ASA test. In a corresponding, if two angles of a triangle ABC are equal to two angles of triangle PQR and the side included by the respective pair of angles are also equal, then the two triangles are congruent. In the given figure, if you see, angle B is congruent to angle Q, side BC is congruent to side QR, and angle C is congruent to angle R. Student, this property is called angle side angle test, which in short ASA test. Now, second property is SAS test. In a corresponding, if two sides of triangle ABC are equal to side of triangle PQR and the angles included by the respective pairs of sides are also equal, then the two triangles are congruent. In the figure, some identical markings are given. Side AB is congruent to side PQ, angle B is congruent to angle Q, side BC is congruent to side QR. This property is called side angle side test, which in short SAS test. Now, third test is SSS test. In a corresponding, if three sides of a triangle ABC are equal to three sides of triangle PQR, then the two triangles are congruent. In the given figure, some identical marking is given. Side AB is congruent to side QP, side BC is congruent to side QR, side AC is congruent to side PR. So student, this property is called side-side-side test, which in short SSS test. Now, our fourth property is hypotenuse side test. If in triangle ABC and triangle PQR, angle B and angle Q are right angle, hypotenuse are equal and AB is equal to PQ, then the two triangles are congruent. In the given figure, if you see, side AB is equal to side PQ, angle B is congruent to angle Q, both are right angle, hypotenuse AC is congruent to hypotenuse PR. So student, this property is called the hypotenuse side test. Now we will start with the practice set number 3.2. Our question number 1 is, in each of the example given below, a pair of triangles is shown. Equal parts of triangle in each pair are marked with the same signs, identical marking. Observe the figure and state the test by which the triangles in each pair are congruent. The first figure is given on your screen. Here you can see side AB is congruent to side PQ, side BC is congruent to side QR, side AC is congruent to side PR. So here we can say by SSS test of congruence, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. Now second figure, if you see here with the identical marking, XY is congruent to side LM, angle Y is congruent to angle M, side YZ is congruent to side MN. So here side angle side test of congruence, triangle XYZ is congruent to triangle LMN. Now our third figure is angle P is congruent to angle S, side PR is congruent to side ST, angle R is congruent to angle T. So by ASA test of congruence, here we can say triangle PRQ is congruent to triangle STU. So next figure is, in this figure, if you see with the identical marking, side LM is congruent to side TP, angle M is congruent to angle T, they are right angle, hypo LN is congruent to hypo PR. So by hypotenuse side test of congruence, triangle LMN is congruent to triangle PTR. Now student, question number 2. Observe the information shown in the pair of triangles given below. State the test by which the two triangles are congruent. Write the remaining congruent part of the triangle. Here student, you have to write congruent part. After writing congruent part, we have to write the remaining congruent part of the triangle. From the information shown in the figure, it is like an activity type question. You have to fill the proper answer for the blank. From the information shown in the figure, in triangle ABC and triangle PQR, angle ABC is congruent to angle PQR, segment BC is congruent to segment QR, angle ACB is congruent to angle PRQ. So triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. Here we can see angle side angle test is used. So angle BAC is congruent to angle QPR, corresponding angle of congruent triangle. Here we can write CACT. Now remaining two sides are remain. Segment AB is congruent to segment PQ, segment AC will be congruent to segment PR. Yeah, our second activity is, the given figure, you have to fill in the blank as per the given information given in the textbook. In triangle PTQ and triangle STR, segment PT is congruent to segment ST. Angle PTQ is congruent to angle STR, they form vertically opposite angle. Segment TQ is congruent to segment TR. Therefore, triangle PTQ is congruent to triangle STR by SAS test. Angle TPQ is congruent to angle TSR. Angle TQP is congruent to TRS. Corresponding angle of congruent triangle. Segment PQ is congruent to segment SR. Corresponding side of congruent triangle.
Question number 3. From the information shown in the figure, state the test assuring the congruence of triangle ABC and triangle PQR. Write the remaining congruent part of the triangle. In the given figure, if you see in triangle ABC and triangle PQR with identical marking, segment AB is congruent to segment PQ, angle A is congruent to angle Q, segment BC is congruent to segment PR. Therefore, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR by hypotenuse side test. Remaining congruent part of a triangle. Here, two segments are already congruent. Third remaining segment is segment AC is congruent to segment QR. CSCT. Angle ABC is congruent to angle QPR. Angle ACB is congruent to angle QRP. They both are corresponding angle of congruent triangle. It means CACT. Question number 4 is, as shown in the following figure, in triangle LMN and triangle PNM, LM is equal to PN, LN equal to PM. Write the test which assure the congruence of the two triangle. Write the remaining congruent part. Now student, as per the given figure, triangle LMN and triangle PNM, segment LM is equal to segment PN, segment LN is equal to segment PM, segment MN is equal to segment NM, common side. The remaining congruent part of a triangle, already three sides are congruent, so remaining congruent parts are three angle of a triangle. Angle L is congruent to angle P, angle M is congruent to angle N, angle N is congruent to angle M by CACT, corresponding angle of congruent triangle. Question number 5. In the figure, segment AB is congruent to segment CB and segment AD is congruent to segment CD. Prove that triangle ABD is congruent to triangle CBD. Given information, segment AB is congruent to segment CB, segment AD is congruent to segment CD. Here we have to prove triangle ABD is congruent to triangle CBD. Proof: from the both triangle ABD and triangle CBD, here we have segment AB is congruent to segment CB, segment AD is congruent to segment CD. That is the given part. Segment BD is congruent to segment BD, the common side of a triangle. Therefore, triangle ABD is congruent to triangle CBD by SSS test of congruence. Question number 6. In the figure, angle P is congruent to angle R, segment PQ is congruent to segment RQ. Prove that triangle PQT is congruent to triangle PQS. Given information, you will write first. The given information is angle P is congruent to angle R, segment PQ is congruent to segment RQ. Here we have to prove that triangle PQT is congruent to triangle RQS. In the both the triangle, we have PQT is congruent to angle RQS. Q is a common angle in both the triangle. Segment PQ is congruent to segment RQ, that is given. Angle QPT is congruent to angle QRS, that is given information. Therefore, triangle PQT is congruent to triangle RQS by ASA test of congruence. I hope you have understood the practice set number 3.2. Thank you for watching this video.